prophets should pray more than they prophesy. What he's saying through me is that your prayer life should exceed your public prophesying. Many prophets prophesy way more than they pray. A lot of stuff that you hear is for you to pray about. A lot of stuff that you see is for you to pray about. So your first calling is to prayer, and then to discern, second calling, discern whether this is something that I should release to the specific individual and to the body of Christ.
Some might disagree. Jesus is our standard. And you have to understand what he has already said in the Word. Specifically, the book of John is one of my favorite. You can go there. And because of his relationship with God, he is trying to show you what you can have. Jesus, when he was in the earth, was trying to tell people he was so close to the Father that if you saw him, if you were during those times, saw him speaking, he was so close that his Father's Spirit was speaking through him. If you saw him doing something, it was what his Father wanted his Son to do. When he told the prophets, they says, when are we going to see the Father? And he says, wait. When you see me, you see the Father. That's what Jesus was saying then. And that is available to those of us who want that type of relationship. But many people don't want to die. You need to die. Our perception about death is still skewed a bit. But you can have that type of relationship where you have a direct line to the Spirit of your Father. Like Jesus said to the disciples, I go to be with my Father and your Father, my God and your God. And so not every apostolic or prophetic vessel is the same, because not everyone is willing to pay the price to be that type of vessel, to be a new creation in Christ Jesus. Our God is spirit. Our God is spirit. The only way we can come up to his level is to die. And because most don't want to die, they don't become what they could become in Christ Jesus. They celebrate our God in heaven. They don't celebrate, put your name in it. They don't celebrate you in heaven. They celebrate God. They don't celebrate your culture or that culture. They celebrate the kingdom of God. They celebrate God. And so that's where we need to be. We need to be a certain place, but are we willing? Are you willing to pay the price to be that new creation of Christ Jesus, what he called you to be?
And so the reality is, being a prophet, being in the office of a prophet, or even exercising the gift of prophecy is and has always been more about a relationship with Father than it is exercising a gift or forthtelling or sharing what you're seeing, word of knowledge, word of wisdom, etc. When you have a relationship with Father, there are some things that are secrets just between you and him, prophetic secrets specifically. That's why he said, call to me and I'll show you great mighty things. Wow. I'll show you things that you don't even know. So many times it's not about a rush, the mad rush to release a prophecy. It's about that intimacy that he wants with you personally. Listen, Miss Cleo and your neighborhood psychic shop can give you a prophecy. It does not mean that they have a relationship with the Most High, Jehovah God. There are plenty of people on Facebook, on YouTube, and other platforms that can prophesy. It does not mean they have a relationship. That's why he said, look, depart from me. You cast out devils in my name. You did all kinds. You prophesied in my name. I don't know you. I do not even know you. So in short, it's about spending time with him in prayer more than it is about prophesying to an individual or to the body of Christ. Your prayer life should exceed what you prophesy.